used to see my grandma when I was growing up bringing cassava home, but I had never experienced how she actually harvests the cassava. That's why we are experiencing this together. I and two people, my champions. So let's see how it's done. Countryside here is so fulfilling. You feed on organic food, no chemicals. That's why you see that people from Ushago or the rural areas are usually very healthy and their immunity is very strong. This is the cassava plant, and cassava is actually a root, so you have to dig deep down there for you to get the cassava. That's what we are doing right now. So let me show you how it's actually done. These are all cassava plants. All the way up to there. Well, this is how the harvesting is done. You have to dig deep in the ground for you to access the cassava. Then you establish the direction in which the cassava has grown. Then you keep digging and covering it from the soil until you get to the root. Life in the countryside is so fulfilling. You uncover new experiences every day. Like, I've never experienced this, yet I eat cassava all the time. So this one is worth over 200 Kenya shillings. Hey, so those people actually make a lot of money.
They do.
There's money back in the countryside, people. If the city is not favoring you, would you shago ukalime manga? Cassava. It's actually a cash crop back here in the countryside. People in the city consume it a lot. So imagine this one right here is worth over 200 Kenya shillings. Imagine.
Ati yote ni chakula sasa. Imeenda hadi wapi? We.
So hiyo sasa. This is how it's done. Aha. Hona, hona hiyo. Huyu ni mkulima hodari, you see, eh? This one can feed a family of 5. After you're done digging, you cover it so that the roots can keep growing, so that next time when you come back, you will harvest another cassava. So this is a tree which never disappoints. You will harvest today, then after how long? After six months. You will come back here and harvest another cassava. After you get it from the garden, then you have to remove the cover. You might decide to wash it first or wash it later after you remove the cover. So this is the next process after you harvest the cassava from the garden. You remove the cover, then you clean it nicely, put some water and boil it. So after you cut it into pieces, you divide the pieces into two. Then you remove this thick fiber at the center here. Apparently, it's harmful. You're not supposed to consume it. Then you wash it, clean it nicely with water. Then you clean them repeatedly for them to be very clean. So these ones will be washed again until all of them are very clean, ready for cooking. Add some water, enough water to cover the cassava. Then you boil them for a while and then you drain the water. You will add some salt as they boil, so that they can be tasty and crunchy once they are ready. And then there you go. You enjoy your cassava with tea or with whatever you like to enjoy it with.
Cassava is a drought-resistant crop, easy to grow, harvest, and store, with a guaranteed market, whether for domestic consumption or for industrial use. All its parts are useful, from the leaves, the stem, the roots, and the fact that it grows well even in less fertile soils makes it an easy-to-grow crop, therefore a staple food in many African countries. Some people consume the leaves, others consume the roots, a diversity which makes the African culture worth exploring. Different cultures, different values, different practices, but we remain one. We are Africans. Interesting, right? So leave a comment down below in the comment section. Let me know which part of cassava you prefer to consume. Do you consume the leaves? Do you consume the root? Leave a comment down below in the comment section. Again, do you like it for breakfast, or do you like it served as a proper meal accompanied by other delicacies?